So today what I'm going to be going over is the software that you're going to need to install and the steps that you're going to need to take to get the EQ6R Pro mount talking to your computer. Now that's going to be the basis of then integrating this with any guiding, plate solving, planetarium, or other software suite that you'd like to integrate this mount with. And as I think you'll see in a minute, this is going to be pretty simple to do. Now, we are going to be breaking up the video into chapters that you can skip forward and backwards through. And additionally, we're going to be releasing a written guide that you can follow along with as well. Check the description below for a link to that. Alrighty, so with all that out of the way, let's go ahead and get this connected up to our computer and get started. Okay guys, so now before we go ahead and connect our EQ6R Pro mount up to the computer, we're gonna first need to install two pieces of software. Now I'm gonna be running through this on a Windows 10 machine. A lot of what I talk about today should transfer over directly to Windows 11 if you've gone ahead and upgraded. And if you're using Mac or Linux, unfortunately what we're gonna be talking about today in this guide won't apply to your operating system. The first program that we're going to need to install is ASCOM. And if you've used astrophotography or astronomy equipment before, this is probably something that you're familiar with or may even already have installed. And so if you've already got it installed, feel free to skip ahead. But if you don't, if you haven't used it yet or don't have it installed, what we're going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and search ASCOM in my browser here. We're going to want to go to the one that is the ASCOM standards website. Go to downloads. And here you can see you can download the ASCOM platform, which I'm going to go ahead and click on here. However, I do already have this installed. Additionally, please pay attention to any prerequisite or other instructions that they may have on here for installing this on your particular machine. Okay, so the next piece of software that we're going to need to install is EQASCOM, or what's commonly referred to as EQMod. So I'm again going to open up a new tab, go to our search bar here, and search for EQASCOM. Now this is going to pull up a couple of results. This is indeed hosted on SourceForge, so we're going to go ahead and click on this listing right here, the one that has the projects, EQMod, files, and EQASCOM. Now you can get to this screen, which is the parent directory. If you land here, note it's not the ASCOM pad folder, it is the EQASCOM folder. So we're going to click on that, and in here we're just going to install the most current version right up at the top there. And so that is going to download as well. Okay, so now that we've got this downloaded, I'm going to go ahead and open the file straight from the downloads bar here. You can also navigate into your downloads folder or wherever your browser is downloading files and launch it from there. We're going to click yes to allow it to modify files on this hard drive. I'm going to go ahead and install the source files as well, just in case any of the prerequisites aren't already installed on this machine. Install. And you can, I'm going to uncheck these. We don't need to view that documentation at this time. However, you can leave these selected if you did want to bring these up and read through it. Okay, so now that we've got all the software installed, the next thing we're going to need to do is connect the mount to the computer. Now, I suggest using a high quality USB-A to USB 2.0 cable, the Apertura cable that I'm using today. Because if you use a lower quality cable, you do run the risk of having some dropouts or connectivity issues. So spending a little bit extra on a cable that you know is going to be reliable is always worth it. So the port that we're going to be connecting this to is the USB port right here on the mount. So I'm just going to take the USB-B end of my cable and plug that in. And now I'm just going to plug the USB-A end into one of the USB ports on my computer, and we'll jump back down for the rest of the configuration. Okay, so with the software installed and our mount now plugged into the computer, the next thing we're going to need to do is power on the mount. So I've just turned the mount on, and what I'm going to do here is navigate to Device Manager. Easy way to do that is to just click the little search bar down at the bottom here and type in Device Manager. You can see that first result popped up. I just hit enter to automatically go to it. You can navigate to it and click on it. Either way, you'll end up here. Now, once you are here, what we're going to go ahead and do is navigate to the ports section here. You're going to want to see the prolific driver right here. And what you're going to want to do is note which COM port this is, because we're going to need to know which COM port the mount is communicating on for some of the later steps in this process. Okay, so now that we've noted what COM port our mount and computer are communicating on, the next thing we're going to want to do is set up the ASCOM device settings. So I'm going to go down to our little search bar here, type in ASCOM device hub. You can see it started to show up partway through there. I'm going to go ahead and click on that to launch it. And that's going to give us this here. So I'm going to go to Tools, Setup, Telescope Device, and here I'm going to click on the big Choose button right here. Now this is going to give us a pop-up window where we can select which device drivers we want to use. By default, it was set on just the simulator setting. You can see some of the other mounts that I use with this machine have drivers that are installed here too. For the purposes of controlling the EQ6R Pro, we want the EQMod ASCOM HEQ5/6 driver. So I'm going to go ahead and select that. Now, if you're doing this for the first time, you're going to get a pop-up that's going to direct you to set the properties for the mount. And so what we're going to need to do on a first-time setup like this is click on this Properties tab. And this will pop up this little display box here. Now with this, we want to make sure that we adjust a few key settings. The first thing that we want to do is make sure that the mount options is set to auto detect. The next things that we want to adjust are the EQ mod port details. You want the timeout set to 1000. You want the retry set to 2. You want the baud rate set to 1152.00. And now we're going to come to the COM port. Now, if you'll recall from earlier in the video, we saw that my mount and computer were communicating on COM port 5. And so that's the one that I'm going to select. Obviously, you're going to want to select the one that corresponds to the COM port you saw earlier when you were looking in the device settings for your particular mount and computer. The next thing that we're going to want to adjust is the ASCOM pulse guiding thing here, and make sure that it is set to ASCOM pulse guide. And then the last thing that you're going to want to do is enter your latitude, longitude, and elevation. Once that's all been entered, you're going to want to leave everything else on its default setting, and then come down and hit the OK button. Now, if you ever want to go back in and adjust something, like say you've moved to a new location or you're using this at a dark site, you can go into the Properties tab again, and you can adjust all of that, and then just go ahead and hit OK.
Once you've got everything set properly, we're going to go ahead and hit OK. We're going to hit OK. We're going to, and now we can connect to the telescope. So as you saw, when you clicked the Connect to Telescope button, this extra window opened up. I've moved both of these so that we can see them a little bit more clearly. And for right now, I'm going to focus on the main one that we started on. Now from here, we can control the mount, and I'm going to go ahead and select 2 degrees per second here, and then press one of the directional buttons. And as we can see, the mount is now moving. I can go ahead and click one of these other buttons to make sure that it's moving in the other, on both axes correctly. And it is. Now, this separate menu that popped up is called the Command Center. And you can control some of the settings from here as well as control the mount with these directional buttons. The rate is going to be different than what we have set here. For instance, if I click this, the mount does move, but very slowly. You can adjust that with these sliders. But one thing that we do want to make sure that we click on while we have this open is the tracking rate. And we want to set that to the sidereal rate. Okay, so those are the basics of how to get this mount connected and set up with the ASCOM system and EQ mod. You're now ready to start integrating this mount into whatever your favorite guiding, planetarium, imaging, plate solving, or other miscellaneous software is. While we're not going to delve into the details on how to do that for all of the popular programs here, you can find a lot of resources online, and typically it's pretty straightforward with the connection tools within those apps.
Okay guys, so that's been the basics of getting your EQ6R Pro connected to your computer and ready for control via whatever software package you'd like to integrate this into. As always, we hope you liked the video, and if you did, we'd appreciate if you gave it a like. If you have any comments, please leave them in the comments section down below. Again, we do have a written version of this guide available. If you'd like to follow along with that, please check the description down below for a link to that. And until next time, clear skies.